Hello out there, and welcome to Your Life with Jimmy. I'm very excited because on today's show, we're going to be talking with the very talented, wildly eccentric, fresh new face on the scene, Mr. Jonny Beauchamp from Showtime, hauntingly beautiful and cinematic, Penny Dreadful.
I trust you shan't be disappointed.
I'm sure not.
Be firm with her. She is willful, like all children.
I hope you know what you've bought.
I do.
Well, talk about a small screen debut. So, Jonny, how do you feel about being introduced to the world in such a revealing way?
Well, at first, it was really daunting, actually. Like, I'm like, wow, like, the first thing anyone's gonna see of me is, you know. So, but then ultimately, I realized, like, you know, I'm actually really lucky to be on such a great show, and boy, I mean, John Logan certainly knows how to make them pay attention.
Moments leading up to the big reveal, you know, how did you get comfortable?
I don't know if I'll ever be comfortable, but I know that was the first scene I shot for the season.
Oh.
Yeah, so it was about 5 a.m. in the morning, and I had 3 scenes to shoot that day. So there was no time to kind of get nervous. You just had to kind of go, go, go.
You've been wowing audiences now for a couple weeks as the very beautiful, provocative Angelique. You know, do you see any of yourself in her?
You know, when you're acting, you always kind of have to bring some of yourself, but I'll say that I wish I was as brave as she is. She's incredibly brave, and she's incredibly direct, which is something I think everybody would really benefit from. I think that as people, we kind of beat around the bush with a lot of things, and Angelique lives in the now, and there's no tomorrow, so she goes for everything, and I really admire that in her.
In terms of physicality, you know, was there anything you did to prepare for Angelique?
Oh, absolutely. In terms of physicality, it's probably the most work I've ever done for a character. It was extremely important for me because I really wanted to honor the community, the trans women, and I didn't want to just play like a boy in a dress because she's not. And so every movement, I kind of tried to like lean more with my eyes because I felt like this was a little bit masculine. The hands, I tried to gently move my hands, you know, only move when I was supposed to. And in terms of like the corset, I mean, Gabriella, the costume director, she's incredible. I made her put that corset on me every day I came to set, even if I wasn't working, because it was really, really tight. And I wanted to be able to move freely
yeah.
with it. I wanted to look like I've been doing it, you know?
Yeah.
And so I actually made them make mine tighter than any of the girls because hey, I'm a boy and we don't have curves. And also I just really wanted to kind of push myself so I can actually do it. So I had a really tight corset on all the time and just kind of walking. I still wanted to honor the women that I was playing.
I understand that you're going to be coming out in the new Roland Emmerich film about Stonewall.
Yes.
Yeah, so that's pretty exciting. I mean, that's a very historical moment in history. Can you share anything
absolutely.
About that with us?
We shot it all in Montreal, mostly on a big warehouse downstage. And so they recreated the entire Christopher Street. And I'd grown up in New York, so me and my friends, you know, we always were down in the village in Christopher Street and stuff. So to see, like, the village cigar sign or to see, you know, like, the big park.
Yeah, brings you right back home.
It was amazing.
And, I mean, your first major movie is, you know, this huge undertaking and working. I mean, Roland Emmerich, Independence Day, The Patriot, you know, he's such an acclaimed director. Were you nervous at all?
Of course. Like, you know, it was my first big movie. I'd never been on a film set to that. You know, I've been on television before, but never like that. And I was working with Jeremy Irvine, you know, Jonathan Rhys Meyers, Ron Perlman. It was incredible, but the nerves went away instantly.
With your role on Penny Dreadful and the upcoming Stonewall, which we're talking about, do you feel that you're helping keep awareness in the transgender community?
Absolutely. I mean, any visibility is visibility, you know, especially in the media. I mean, I don't think I met all a front runner in that race, but I, you know, especially with the incredible Laverne Cox. I mean, she is a trans woman, and so I feel honored that I got to help with that story. Like Angelique, this is Victorian England, 1800s, so there really wasn't any kind of augmentations or anything like that. So they really kind of needed a male to portray for the show, and so I'm honored that I got do that And I absolutely want to bring awareness because, you know, this is not a new construct. This is something that's been happening since the beginning and it's been kind of rewritten out of history and kind of moved around, but these people were respected and honored for centuries before.
Yeah.
And so I think it's important, and I'm so glad that there's a lot of attention to that now. I think that's very much the next frontier.
Do you worry at all about being typecast?
I've definitely gotten some advice from people saying, you know, you shouldn't take roles like that, especially early on or whatever, but I really can't let that. If I looked at acting like that, I wouldn't do anything.
Yeah.
You know, nothing would be good enough. So I really just look at the project. It's John Logan. I love the writing. And I really intrigued by the character. I thought Angelique was immense. I did a lot of research on it. And for this person to be so bold and to kind of, you know, address Dory in the way she does, like, you know, she's a woman not with, you know, any kind of man with her. You know, she's walking the streets and she sits at his table.
Yeah.
And that didn't happen. And not only is she's as a woman, but she has a secret. And she is young, and it is a dangerous world, and there is no laws protecting her, and there is no family. So she's really, I think she's immensely brave. And to be able to play that, I mean, like, that only helps you. And, you know, I've learned a lot from Angelique. You know, never to waste the moments and really kind of...
Go for it.
Yeah.
Because tomorrow's not promised. And I think that, especially back then, there was no tomorrow, you know, for the likes of Angelique. But she's proud, and she is her whole self, which is something I think that everybody can both identify with and aspire to be.
Before we go, we're going to do a round of rapid fire. I like to do this with my guests. I'm going to ask you a series of questions. Answer as fast as you can the first thing that comes to you.
Okay.
Are you ready?
Yeah.
Okay. Favorite junk food?
We love cheese fries.
Favorite curse word?
Motherfucker.
Twitter or Instagram?
Instagram.
Last song that was stuck in your head?
Eye of the Tiger.
Where do you see yourself in 5 years?
Hopefully doing what I'm doing, you know? I would love that.
Thank you so much for being here.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Jonny Beauchamp.